सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तं वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
अण्डर्स्टाण्ड्, अक्सेप्ट् ओन्ली द हानर् फ्रम् द पर्सन् हुस् एक्स्पीरियन्स्ड् यू, was experienced you. He can never dishonor you. Even if he dishonors, he will only be suffering, you will not be suffering. Living on the dharmic line, understand, living on the dharmic line, having a clear understanding about you and allowing the people who experience you to honor you, you will see, even if that same person dishonors you, you will not be touched in any way, because dharma is so powerful, it stands even inside your inner space and protects you. If you follow the law, you are protected in the outer world. If you follow the dharma, you are protected in the inner world. You will never fall in depression. We bother so much about following the law to have the protection from the outer world. Understand, follow the dharma too, you will never fall into the difficulties and disturbances which comes from the inner world. I tell you, the inner world problems are much more stronger and difficult and dangerous than the outer world problems. Because if the inner world problems happens, immediately you are shaken, you will invite outer world problems. You will invite outer world problems. Being dharmic, that is what Mahadeva means here. In all your relationships, let you be dharmic, let you be clear. You will see, when dharmically somebody who experienced you, even if he dishonors you, you will not feel affected. That person only will fall into the depression. Understand, just like a law which is clear, logic, enforced properly, dharma too is enforced. Dharma is also properly enforced and it is still alive. Please understand, we are all happening, enlightened beings are happening again and again in the planet Earth. Just to remind you one line, dharma is still alive. The cosmic law is still alive. The dharma, there's a beautiful one-liner, dharmo rakshati rakshitaha. When you protect it, it will protect you. The dharma is so powerful. Many people ask me, no, Swamiji, I have seen good people suffering, bad people. Good people like me are suffering, bad people like my enemies are enjoying. Understand. Please understand the truth. First thing, good people never suffer. It may appear like suffering. And if there is suffering, understand, somewhere the dharma was lost. Dharma was lost. The altered understanding, I always tell, viparyayanyana, the perverted understanding. Perverted understanding is not dharma. Dharma means clear, honest to your center, to your understanding. One more important thing, you don't even have to be honest to the higher understandings which has not become part of your experience. No. Be honest and true to your understanding. That is more than enough. If you are in the level of dharma, just completely be in that dharma. They call it swadharma, being in tune, honest with the dharma, which is your core. You will see, there will not be any unnecessary movement. There will not be any falling into the low mood. There will not be any moving this way and that way. Dharmo rakshati rakshitaha. Dharma, when you protect it, it protects you. And I tell you, when you protect the dharma, it gives such a strength, so so much of courage. Traditionally, Brahmana is supposed to derive his strength from the enlightenment. Kshatriya and Vaishya are supposed to derive strength from Dharma. And the person who is working is supposed to derive strength from his master's Dharma. Understand? It's a very beautiful description. How you are supposed to derive strength. Dharma will give the strength. Otherwise, especially in the war, in the battlefield, how will you know who is right, who is wrong? In the world of Kshatriya, and one important thing, we never had the problem of the person who wins writes the history. No. The civilization which is built on brutality, which is built on physical power, in this kind of civilizations, always the person who won, he wrote the history. But in our Indian tradition, unbiased, even the kings who lost have been remembered as heroes. In many places, kings who lost the kingdom have been remembered as heroes. They have been highlighted in the history. Means, history is not written by the person who won the war. It was written based on the line of Dharma. It was centered on the basis of Dharma.